नमस्ते चिल्ड्रन, टुडे लास्ट वीडियो लास्ट पीपीटी वी डील विथ नाउन्स, काइंड्स ऑफ नाउन्स. अंडर दैट अगेन वन मोर पार्ट इज देयर, दैट इज जेंडर. अंडर द नाउन्स वी आर डीलिंग विथ टुडे जेंडर. हियर दिस इज यूनिट 12, पेज नंबर 66. वी हैड मेड इट, सी वी मेड according to practice book. We made this grammar syllables according to practice book. So after the kinds of nouns, you have to come to gender. Now gender okay, read the following sentences. Boy plays football. Second one, the girl sings well. Third one, the table is made of food. Fourth one, the baby is asleep. Asleep or sleep is okay. So here, gender, to find out the genders here. Read the following sentences. After read that, see that what is the given in the box. The noun, boy, is the name of a male. It is therefore said to be masculine gender. You have to remember that male genders are masculine. See the spelling. M-A-S, masculine, masculine gender. Okay. The word masculine means male, and so the names of all male persons or animals are said to be of the masculine gender, as man, boy, uncle, son, brother, king, lion, tiger, etc. These are all the male genders. King, okay, duke, these are all the male genders. Here the noun girl is the name of a female. It is therefore said to be feminine gender. Female nouns are feminine gender. Okay. The word feminine comes from a word meaning woman. 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 See this pronunciation? It's a woman. And so the names of all female persons are animals. Remember that persons are animals. In which here mosquito, male mosquito, female mosquito. Generally, in the animals and the persons only male and female will be. Okay. Are said to be of the feminine gender, as woman, girl, aunt, daughter, sister, queen, lioness, etc. See, male, man is male gender, woman is female gender, boy is male, girl female, uncle male, aunt female, son male, daughter female, brother male, sister female, king male, queen female, lion male, lioness female. See that. Then the noun table is the name of the thing without life. It is therefore said to be neuter gender. Neuter means not either masculine, not either, example, neither masculine nor feminine. Here, not either, neuter means not either. What is the meaning of neuter means not either? It is the, it doesn't have male or female. Neither masculine nor feminine. This is a neuter means neither masculine nor feminine. Things without life cannot be either male or female. Simple, remember thing. Non-living things. Neuter started with N. Non-living things started with N. In that way you remember that. Non-living things comes under neuter gender. Hence the names of such things are said to be the neuter gender. As house, thief, tree, chair, table, desk, wall, etc. These are the new genders. There is no life for that. House, no life. If no life, three no life, chair no life, table, desk, ball, like that. Okay. Next. Here, the noun baby may be used for the both male baby and a female baby. It is therefore said to be the common gender. Common gender means either male or female. Neuter means neither male nor female. Neither nor either are. Please, neither means no, negative. Either means you have chance. Common, whether male or female. But we use for both the same. Suppose child. If I say child, the boy or girl. If I say only boy, it's a masculine. If I say girl, feminine. If I say child, either boy or girl, anyone. Okay. Nouns which may be used for both males and females are said to be of the common gender. The word child may mean either a male child or a female child. It is a word common both boys and girls. But not only boys and girls, for all child, yes, just I said that child is common for both boys and girls. Words like child, friend, cousin, person, pupil, teacher are said to be nouns in the common gender. Here remember that there are four kinds of genders. One is masculine, second one is feminine, third one is neuter, fourth one is common. Masculine means male nouns, feminine means female nouns, neuter means non-living things, and common gender means either male or female. Teacher, you say teacher, male teacher will be, female teacher will be. I think you just watch the video again. If you did not get gender, after watching only you should come here. You know, that you will get a good concept there. There are three ways in which feminine noun can be formed from masculine noun. Three ways in which feminine. So how adding feminine, this feminine noun form from masculine noun. Okay. From the male noun, female noun will come. There are three ways. In the three ways, feminine noun will form. Here, masculine noun and feminine. By adding es. By adding es to the male noun, then it will convert into female noun. Male noun, lion is a male noun. What you add es is, it will come female noun. Simple. You can remember, is very simple. Three ways are there, no? You just remember this. Okay. Lion, lioness, poet, poet, poetess, priest, priestess, author, authoress, prince, princess, shepherd, shepherdess, host, hostess, count, countess, heir, heiress. Okay. Sometimes the form is slightly changed before ESS is added. See. Songster. Songstress will come. See. R will go to T and E will come after R. Actor. Actress. Adding ESS only. But when entered here R. Hunter. Huntress. Tiger, tigress, benefactor, benefactress, master, mistress, duke, duchess, emperor, empress. See here, adding ess only, but slightly changed before ess. Ess before hunter, er will be here, r will be. Okay, e is skipped from here. Actor. Actress, O skipped from here. Songster, seer, E skipped from here. And came after R. Okay, skipped from here. Tiger, E skipped from here. Skipped means removed, missed from there. Okay, like, do you see that spelling? Once, twice, thrice, if you read, you can remember this kind. Whenever exams, I may ask from these any word from this page. So you should remember that it should be followed here. Empress, god, goddess, governor, governess, master, mistress, waiter, waitress. Okay, here master repeated here, master, master. Okay, then note, study how the following feminine are formed. You should do the hard work. No, don't just learn behind it. You observe and learn. Then you can remember easily. Here, heroine, hero, heroine. Bridegroom, bride. Widower, widow. Sir, madam. Lad, lass. Mr., miss. Here, by a different word. Second one, by adding ess, by a different word here. There is a similar nouns are there by removing e and add ess at the end. That here directly add ess. Here some different similarities there. Here in the first one, the feminine female nouns are formed from the male nouns. Similarity is there in the female and male nouns. But here, second one, by a different word means male and female totally different. There is no similarity. See here, boy, girl, there is no similarity. You come to know that by calling that name, you come to know which gender is that. Like that, you should observe. You should learn by observing that. Okay? Bachelor, maid. Boy, girl, brother, sister, bull, cow, cock, hen, dog, bitch, all countess, countess, okay, count also we say that, uncle, aunt, gentleman, lady, horse, maid, husband, wife, son, daughter, king, queen, man, woman, nephew, niece, monk, nun, papa, mama, sir, madam, okay. The following are examples of nouns in the common gender. Okay. See, parent, relation, friend, cousin, bird, deer, servant. It's not deer, beta, it's deer. Servant, teacher, child, baby, orphan, pupil, student, person. These are the common nouns. If you say parent, whether male or female, relation, male or female friend, male friend or female friend, boyfriend or girlfriend, cousin, either sister or brother, bird, male bird or female, deer means male or female, servant means male servant or female servant, like that. Okay. Now third one, feminines of compound nouns. Compound noun means two nouns together we form. That is the noun. It will become a compound. Compound noun means two nouns together will form. Okay. It's two nouns. Gentleman, gentleman, gentle plus man will become gentleman. Grandfather, grand plus father will come grandfather. Just a compound noun. Compound male nouns, compound female nouns. Here, this is also if you know this end word, man, woman. Father, mother, man, maid, servant, servant. But here some difference is there. You observe this. Gentleman, gentlewoman, grandfather, grandmother, milkman, milkmaid, man servant, maid servant, fisherman, fisherwoman. You learn this fisherman and fisherwoman in the true friend lesson. Stepson, stepdaughter, stepfather, stepmother, landlord, landlady, he goat, she goat. Washerman, washerwoman, peacock, peahen, like cock hen also. Okay, cock hen is normal female noun. Here, peacock, peahen. This is the compound noun. Note that the pronoun he is used instead of a singular masculine noun. She is used instead of a singular feminine noun. He means male noun. You know very well, he, she, it, I, we, you, they, these are the pronouns. He always used for male noun. She always used for female noun. Okay. and it is used instead of a singular neuter noun. Neuter, it means non-living things. For non-living things we use it. But I, we, you, they, he, she, it. I is also again common noun. I means either male or female. It is always used for neuter noun. He always used for female noun. She always used for he always used for male noun. She always used for female noun. Okay. There are seven pronouns. I, we, personal pronouns. Those are I, we, you, they, he, she, it. I means either male or female, comes under common. We means a group of nouns, so we can't consider. You, either male or female. I, we, you, they means again a group of nouns, we can't consider. And I, we, you, they, he, she, it. He means boys, she means girls, means male nouns, female nouns, and it always used for neuter. Here example is given here. The king went to the palace. What is a king? Male. So he ate his breakfast. Remember that based on this exercise is also there. King. King is male, so we have to use pronoun he. The queen went to the palace. Same sentence, changed with the noun. Queen is a female noun. So you have to replace with female pronoun. She ate her breakfast. The king lived in the palace. Palace is a place name. So neuter. It was made by white marble. Made of white marble. It means is a non-living thing. Palace is a non-living thing. So obviously it is a neuter noun. Neuter noun always replaced with the it pronoun. The pronouns they and them may be masculine, feminine or neuter. As a group of nouns, no, we can't say whether male or female. Suppose I'll tell a sentence. Children are playing in the ground. They are my class children. So they means here children, either male or female in that. Okay, like that. The boys have just returned home. They must be hungry. Give them some to eat. I mentioned here the boys, so it will become masculine. If I say children, they are not the masculine, they are not the feminine, they are a common noun. The girls have been to the cinema. Ask them if they enjoyed the picture. Have been to the cinema means they went. They are at the cinema. They went to cinema. Ask them if they enjoyed the picture. So here I mentioned girls, particularly girls. So it will be feminine. The books on the table are mine. They are Mary. Beautiful. They have many beautiful pictures in them. So neuter. Books are non-living things. No, it comes under neuter. Based on the first two sentence, this first the pronoun will be whether noun, feminine noun or masculine noun or a neuter. When a noun changes from masculine to feminine, the pronoun in the sentence must change to. See, remember that. See here, I will tell one. See that sentence. The king went into the hall. He ate his breakfast. King, we are using here king. So based on the, what is the king pronoun? He. What is object pronoun? His. We can't say the king went into the hall. She ate her breakfast. We can't say this because king is a male gender. Male noun. Next, the same sentence is replaced with queen. The queen went into the hall. Queen female noun, no? Obviously, we have to use she pronoun. And objective pronoun, her. She ate her breakfast. We can't say the queen went into the hall. He ate his breakfast. We can't say. Or she ate his breakfast. No, we can't say. Okay. His uncle has a car. He goes to the office in his car. Uncle what is the, is it male noun or female noun? Yes, male noun. So we have to replace with male pronouns. He, her aunt has a car. She goes to the office in her car. Aunt, male or female? Male, female. So we have to use female pronouns. The father loved the eldest son very much. Father. He used father, but there is no replacing word here. Father. The father loved the eldest daughter also, you can say. There is no combination here. You can use any kind of noun here. But you can't use any pronoun. The mother loved the eldest daughter very much. The mother loved the eldest son also, we can say. There is no relation, no. It's not replacing word. It's a noun, separate nouns. We can change separate nouns. It's not related one on another. But here, relation should be there. If aunt, if we kept, we have to use female pronoun. If uncle kept, we have to use male pronoun. But we should not use for uncle female pronoun. We should not use for aunt male pronoun. But here there is no relation. They can say the daughter also in the center. Or in the father place mother also we can keep. Okay. See the observe the sentences carefully. Then you can answer. You know that concept, but understanding is needed. His brother is an actor. He always played the part of a hero in the film. His sister is an actress. So brother is said that's an actor. So brother is now, you know, replaced with a male noun, male pronouns. Here sister is an actress. So replaced with the female pronouns. Here exercises will come now. Now onwards. Here, give the gender of the nouns in color. See, the boy, there are 30 boys in our class. Boys, what is this? This boys and class. These two are the nouns. Wherever nouns are there must be a gender. May, boys. Which gender? Masculine. So I couldn't write here masculine. Masculine. Okay, masculine. Then class. Common. Class is non-living thing, no? Sorry, neuter. Class is non-living thing, then it is neuter. The prince. Male. Rode on a male. Male, female. Male is female. The princess played with her lamb. Princess. What is the princess? Female. Lamb. Lamb. Male or female? Lamb. Lamb opposite gender is laid. Okay. We come to now. I will tell now. Then the mother loved the child. Mother is female. Child is male. The teacher loves his people. Teacher is common. Peoples is also common. Your child is common. I have 5 nephews and 2 nieces. Nephews is male and the nieces is female. Masculine, feminine we should write, sorry. Nephews is masculine and nieces is feminine. The master treated the servants kindly. Master is masculine, servant is common. As male servant, maid servant is not men, so it is common. The king and the queen loved him. King is male masculine noun, queen is feminine noun. His uncle and aunt loved him. So uncle is masculine and aunt is feminine. The bridegroom brought the bride home. Bridegroom is male masculine noun and bride is feminine noun. Here I will tell number what is that. Okay. Give the feminine of the following. Duke, that is washerman. Common noun, yes, washerwoman. Son, right, daughter. Nephew, it's not nephew, beta, nephew. Nephew, niece. Husband, wife. Cock, hen. Monk, nun. Prince, princess. Shepherd, shepherdess. Shepherdess. King, queen. Milkman, milkwoman. Peacock, peahen. Bull, cow. Boy, girl. Horse, mare. Bridegroom, bride, hero, heroine, uncle, aunt, emperor, empress, sir, madam, widower, widow, host, hostess. To write answers, I will send. First you write what you know, write. Later we will do. Now, give the masculine of the following. Knees. Here in the previous page. Okay, I can't. In the previous page 70, we had given 69. They asked the feminine noun. Here, male nouns they asked. Female nouns given. Niece, nephew, waitress, waiter, witch, wizard, mare, horse, tigress, tiger, wife, husband, bride, bridegroom, countess, count, daughter, son, hostess, host, madam, sir, lass, laid. Bitch, dog, landlady, landlord, nun, monk, widow, widow, mother, father, authoress, author. So, exercise 4. Rewrite the following sentences using nouns and pronouns of the opposite gender. Here, till we had done in the grammar book, here, there is no place to write here. So, we have to write in the classwork. I had given at the end of this video, so I said that lamb is male, female is Eve lamb. I couldn't go back, I don't know why. Lamb is so lamb is male and Eve lamb is female. Eve lamb, E-V-E-L-A-M-B. Okay, I will send the pictures. That time you do the spelling, you see the spelling. So, exercise 4, rewrite the following sentences using nouns and pronouns of the opposite gender. See, here nouns we have to see, these nouns and these pronouns. Also, we have to keep our mind while changing the sentences. Here they had given you. His nephews and brothers came to see him. His opposite gender is what? Is his male gender, masculine gender. Feminine gender is what? Her. Her nephews opposite gender, nieces. And the brothers opposite gender, sisters. Came to see him. See her, sorry. See? See. Watching his nephews, brothers and him. These four you have to change. Remaining as easily you write. See, bridegroom, horse, father, doctor is common, we can't change. He. Okay, hospital is. And daughter and washerman. Here, uncle. Him, simple. Your it is not, no need to change. Remaining will be the same. So like that you have to change into male noun into female noun. Either male, if male is there, you have to change into female. If female is there, you have to change into male. So do this exercise. I have given it the end and I will send the pictures, but you should do your own way. Okay, it should be written in the class. Okay, after that exercise, the kinds of nouns exercise after, you have to write this exercise 4, page number 17, and keep the grammar on the top and rewrite the sentence. After writing this heading, you change the sentence. First you write the question, then write the answers. Okay. Now exercise 5. Choose the correct word from the bracket and underline it. This is my nephew. See here. He's called Sita. How should you know? You can keep either niece or she. Both are given. So based on this noun, you can come to know that whether he or she. So she and nephew. Now read the sentence. This is my nephew. Sorry. So this is my niece. This is my niece. She is called Sita. Now his uncle, his dash, hero, husband. So based on this husband, we can say that the noun is a female noun. So this one. His aunt is a widow. Widow is also given here. His aunt is widow. Her husband was a great scholar. The boy has just come home. Ask. See here the boy. Based on this boy, that given noun, whether male or female, you have to choose. Ask him if he wants his dinner. Okay. Her. Based on that her, you can say that her have husband, not the wife. Her doesn't have wife. Her always have husband. So, treated her kindly. The king, the dash lost her bag of gold. Anyone will come? The king, her is given. So, the king, the queen lost her bag of gold. Her wife, husband looked after him based on the him. Him always have the wife only. So, her his wife looked after him. Okay, the woman and man saved her or his husband from death. Husband. So what will come here? The woman saved her husband from death. The man, woman felt the loss of dear wife and husband. The man felt the loss of his dear wife. Okay, this is the gender. Okay, now you have to do this classwork. I will send the pics. And first, before that, you have to watch that gender video which I made in the month of April. Thank you.